to the secret place, just an old.
Why don't you stand up on your feet? We're going to worship together in our hearts. Leave your mask on, but let's worship together. Well, let's sing a song of faith together. darkness has to retreat. Just one touch. Just one touch. I feel the presence of God. Just one touch. My eyes were open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that I can't do. There's not a mountain that he can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do. Come on, just one word. Just one word. You heal what's broken inside. And just one word. And you revive every dream.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and do not forget all his benefits. who forgives all our iniquity, who heals all our diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy, who satisfies you with good as long as you live, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord works vindication and justice for all who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, his acts to the people of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. He will not always accuse, nor will he keep his anger forever. He does not deal with us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are as high above the earth, so great is his steadfast love towards those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far he removes our transgressions from us. As a father has compassion for his children, so the Lord has compassion for those who fear him. Now, at church and at home, let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Incarnate God, we are amazed at your great love for us. For the creator of the universe to come to earth as one of us is both mind-boggling and humbling. To leave the splendor of heaven and empty yourself as a means to connect with us demonstrates just how much you truly love the people of this world.
Lord Jesus, we are grateful for your sacrifice and for the gift of your Holy Spirit that resides in all of us. Forgive us when we allow things in our lives to distract us from this amazing truth. Remind us of your message to us. We are to love one another as you have loved us. May we continually see in the other the hungry, the prisoner, the sick, the lonely, and the marginalized people in our society.
Holy Spirit, enable us to be your voice and your hands as we encounter people along our life's path. May our actions reflect your love, and may we see your love reflected in others. Use us, Lord, to bring the kingdom of heaven to earth. May we follow in your footsteps, forgiving one another, bringing healing to damaged relationships and broken people.
And now, Lord, we pray on behalf of those in our community who have need. We ask for your mercy and healing for Robin Cahigas Grimes as she undergoes a very serious surgery. Give her and her family strength and peace of mind. Work through the hands of the doctors to repair the damaged arteries in her head and neck.
On behalf of all those who are suffering from despair, loneliness, financial concerns, relationship disputes, and fear, we pray for that peace that is beyond anything we can comprehend. Use your people, Lord, to bring relief to those in need. Open our eyes and direct us in the way we should go.
At this time, you are invited to speak aloud any prayer request that you have. If you are listening online, please use the comment section to voice your requests. We'll read them aloud here for you.
So if you'll stay in your seats and wear your mask, but you can feel free to speak out your requests, and we'll agree with you and pray with you. And Alan will be checking the live feed. Any prayer requests? Everybody's doing great. That's awesome. Praise God. Or testimonies, any praise reports? Anybody got, doesn't have to be a need, it can be a praise. Even in a virtual world, my shows are being done. Praise God.
Praise God.
Theater's still happening. Schools are still opening. Yes? Awesome. Happy birthday.
Happy
we
birthday.
Have a birthday. All right. Praise God. Better shape today than he was last year. That's awesome. Praise God. That's great. That's great. Well, we just want to agree, even if you have something unspoken in your heart, whether it be a request or a praise, we'll agree with you today. Hear our prayers, God, that we may love you with our whole being and willingly share the concerns of our neighbors. Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Greater far than tongue or pen can ever tell. It goes beyond the highest star and reaches to the lowest hell. The guilty pair bowed down with care. God gave his son to win. His erring child he reconciled and pardon from his sin. Oh, love of God, how rich and pure, how measureless and strong. It shall forevermore endure the saints and angels' song. Of time shall pass away, and earthly thrones and kingdoms fail, when men who hear refuse to pray, on rocks and hills and mountains call. God's love so sure shall still endure, all measureless and strong, redeeming grace to every race, the saints and angels' song. Oh, love of God, how rich and pure, how measureless and strong. It shall forevermore endure, the saints and angels' song. Could we think the ocean fill, and were the skies of parchment made, were every tree on earth a quill, and every man a scribe by trade, to write the love of God above.
Again, how's everyone doing? Good. Your voices still work, right? Even with these on? Yeah, everyone doing well? Awesome. I'm so glad to be here with you all. I can't even talk about it. It's so good to see your faces, like the top third of your faces. Now's the time in our service where we're going to share grace and peace. So we're going to turn on some music. We encourage you to just kind of, the music's not going to be loud, But we encourage you to just kind of stay where you're at in the sanctuary, but turn around, talk to people, keep your distance, keep your mask on. But go ahead and greet one another in the Lord, and we're glad, we're so, so glad to be able to just be here together and do that live right here. We want to say hi to everyone watching on our live stream. Hi, everybody. Everybody turn around and wave at everybody on the live stream. Actually, wave at this camera right here. They're looking at you on this camera, so everybody wave. And thank you, Mikkel. Thank you, tech team, for everybody running the live stream right now. Let's give those guys a hand for everybody at home. But yeah, right now, let's just take a minute and say grace and peace. Let me say to you in person, grace and peace. We've got Robin Wingo saying hi on the live stream. We've got Angela Waddell at home on the live stream, Patty Larinaga, Ashley Fisher. There are some prayer requests, so I'll go ahead and voice those because they're coming in. The live stream's a little behind us. We'll keep that in mind for next week because it's a learning curve, right? So we want to pray for our president, first lady, everyone who's suffering from COVID right now still. We want to pray for swift relief for them and, you know, relief from that. We want to pray for Lauren, our brother Lauren, who's suffering from cancer. He's dealing with chemo treatments right now. We're keeping you in prayer, Lauren. We want to pray for Garrett, who has COVID and is on a ventilator. We got Wayne and Leslie Howard watching on the live stream. Hey, Kristen Howell on the live stream. Hey, Ed and Susan. Daniel Terry, who remembers that guy? All right, go ahead and turn around, say grace and peace to one another. It's so good to see you guys this morning. Grace and peace.
Good morning, Oasis. It's so great to be together worshiping both in person and online. We want to make sure that you're aware of all of the events that we have coming up. First of all, we are participating in the Polk Ecumenical Action Council for Empowerment, better known as PEACE. This is an organization of churches here in Polk County that's existed for many years and has done some amazing work affecting positive social change in our area. We're excited to be a part of what they're doing, but a requisite of our involvement is that we have a series of listening sessions. If you've already attended one of our listening sessions online, thanks so much for being a part of those. If you are still interested in being a part of our involvement with PEACE, but have not attended one of those listening sessions, there are two left. They're both today. One is at 2 p.m. and one is at 6 p.m. If you are still interested and would like to be a part of one of those listening sessions, be sure to please, please, please email me. I'm at mlarinaga@oasischurch.org. and let me know which of those sessions you'd like to attend, either 2 or 6, and I will make sure that you have the information you need to get into that meeting. Connect is our young adult ministry for ages 18 to 30-ish. If you're in that age group, we are getting together next Sunday, the 11th, at 4:30 p.m. at Peterson Park. If you'd like more information, you can email me, or you can also go to oasischurch.org and click on the events tab. We want to remind those of you who are attending in person that we are doing everything we can to keep one another safe. Masks are required at all times while inside the building, and they must cover the nose and tuck under the chin. We're encouraging everyone to wash their hands frequently and thoroughly. There are hand sanitizing stations around the building. Please maintain 6 feet of distance at all times. And if you're not feeling well today, we're going to encourage you to worship from home. Thank you to those of you who are tuning in online. We're glad to have you here. Well, now is the time in our service where we will receive our tithes and our offerings. As ever, there are 4 ways to give here at Oasis. You can give in person by dropping your donation in the box that's in the back of the auditorium or at the welcome desk in the lobby. You can give online at oasischurch.org/give. You can text any amount to 84321 and you will receive prompts on how to complete that contribution. And you can also give via the Church Center app, which is an amazing way to stay on top of everything that's going on coming up in the calendar. Let's pray to receive that offering. Father, thank you for everything you do for us. Thank you for giving us the means to keep ourselves and each other safe, Lord. We thank you for the resources that we have. We thank you for the generosity with which they are given, Lord. And we pray for wisdom and clarity and creativity on how to use what we receive to be a blessing in our community and to one another. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
If God had a name, what would it be? Would you call it to his face? If you were faced with him, to believe in things I care for.
back up to heaven all alone. Nobody calling and checking on the phone. Except the Pope, maybe. When I say,
it has been way too long, and I have missed you so much. I imagine a lot of you have seen me, you know, fairly often, you know, on video, but I haven't gotten to see you. And so welcome. Welcome to all of you who are here today. Welcome to everyone who's online today. We're glad that we're together in this new, unique way in which we are together. So we're continuing a new series that we started last week called Then Sings My Soul. And we're looking at various songs because songs have these kind of this power to communicate and to move us, to connect with us in ways that are beyond simply our thoughts and words, but our emotions and our feelings. This song, and thank you to Carol so much for that rendition of it. It was beautiful. The song, if I'm correct, came out in 1995. Joan Osborne is the original artist. And I remember I was in my kind of last year of seminary at the time. And I both loved the song, I was drawn to it, and it also made me a little nervous. You know, all that talk about God being like us or being a slob on a bus. Excuse me. I'm like, I don't think you should talk about God that way. And the interesting thing about it is that I think that that idea that somehow we shouldn't talk about God that way comes from a misconception about what humans are. Like we think that somehow being human is to be kind of corrupt, right? We take this idea that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. And we think that must mean, therefore, that we are kind of horrific things, these evil, kind of corrupt creatures. But when God created, God said, this is good. When God created humanity, he said, this is very good. God loves us. So I think part of it has to do with maybe redefining what we think it means to be human. And I think that could be helpful. This song had a reoccurrence of popularity a few years after its original release. It became the opening soundtrack for a TV show called Joan of Arcadia, which was a playoff of Joan of Arc. I'm not overly familiar with the show. I'm more familiar, actually, with Joan of Arc, who was a remarkable person who God spoke to her. She had this very existential faith. Like she would hear from God. She would have dreams and visions, and she would kind of act based upon that. And in the TV show, Joan of Arcadia, she gets met with people, and then the person will talk to her, and it's God kind of speaking through that person. Now, on one level, I think that sounds pretty mystical and a little paranormal, but I like it because it's a TV show. But on another level, I think we often say this, right? If we're in need and someone provides for our need, we'll say that God has done something for us. I mean, have any of you either had this happen to you or you've known that it happened to someone else? They were in need and someone gave them money, or they were in need and someone gave them some food, or they fixed their car, or they provided something for them, and we say, praise the Lord, God has provided. Well, how has God provided? Well, a lot of the times, God provides through us. Scripture will say that we are the body of Christ. And so as we respond to the nudging and the calling of God to do what's right with our families, with our communities, right? That is God kind of working through us. We become the hands and feet, literally the body of Christ, right? That's at work. So Alexander Pope wrote a poem. Well, he was a marvelous poet. But one of his poems contains this line that's often quoted. It says, to err is human, but to forgive, divine. Now, you might think that kind of fits into the idea that humans are completely and utterly kind of corrupt and can do no good, and God is the one who has to forgive them. But that's not exactly what Pope is saying. Pope is saying, yes, it is part of what it means to be human is to make mistakes. We are finite. We have limitations. But the first humans in Genesis, Adam and Eve, were also finite. They also had limitations. They weren't infinite. They weren't God. They were creation. They didn't know everything. In fact, there's a lot of things they didn't know, right? They couldn't do everything. They weren't all powerful. They weren't omnipresent. They weren't everywhere, right? So they were human, right? So it's not so much that to err is human. We all make mistakes. But what Pope is saying in his poem is that to forgive is divine, and he's calling humanity to behave that way. You see, the church came to the conclusion, eventually, that Jesus was the fullness of humanity. Well, you say that Jesus is fully divine and Jesus is fully human. And when we talk about the humanity of Jesus, it seems like a difficult subject to get our minds around because we know who we are. We know the types of mistakes that we make. And we think that Jesus must not be like that. And so we kind of discount Jesus' humanity and we focus rather on Jesus' divinity. Doing that, though, is a precarious activity. Because in the biblical books of 1 John and 2 John, it says that the one who denies Jesus' humanity speaks with the spirit of Antichrist. That to say that Jesus isn't human, to embrace the humanity of Jesus, is to be anti-Christ. Early in the church, there was this belief that somehow all things that were physical, were temporal, were also evil, like our desires and our bodies, the things of the world, things that were made of matter. And that somehow we were going to leave all that behind and become these kind of spiritual beings. But the early church rejected that idea, right? They embraced the idea that our good God was the creator, and that God made a good creation, and that God came in the flesh as a human. And not only did Jesus come as a human, but after his death, it wasn't like his death just paid our debt and then he went on to be with the Lord like anyone else you might have known who was a Christian and died, right? Jesus didn't just go to heaven when he died. There was a resurrection of the body. Jesus coming out of the tomb is an affirmation of the goodness of creation. That that what it means to be human. So Jesus didn't come so we could become angelic. Jesus came so we could be human in the fullness of our humanity. One way to think about this, I know it's kind of a complex topic, and how are we supposed to think or act based on this? It's sometimes when we're talking about things that are difficult to define, and certainly God would fit into that category, it's sometimes helpful if we think about what it's not. So Paul will do this some in 1 Corinthians 13 when he's talking about love. He says what love is. It's patient and it's kind. But then he'll also tell us what love is not. It's not rude. It's not boastful. This kind of via negativa, right? It's a negative way of describing something by saying what it's not. So let's think about that in terms of humanity. So you know the word inhumane, like an inhumane treatment of animals, we'll say. If somebody's guilty of inhumane treatment of animals, what have they done to their animals? They've neglected them. They haven't fed them. They've perhaps even abused them, beaten them, right? We call that an inhumane treatment of something or someone, because a human treatment of them would be to care for them, to love them, to meet their needs, to treat them kind of in a valuable way. I'd like to, if you have your Bibles, whether here or if you're watching digitally, or if you're watching this sometime later today or later in the week, if you're watching the recording, right? You can turn to 1 John chapter 4. 1 John chapter 4, and I'm reading from the NRSV. It says, "Beloved, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see whether they are from God. For many false prophets have gone out into the world. By this you know the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is from God. And every spirit that does not confess Jesus is not from God. And this is the spirit of the Antichrist, of which you have heard that it is coming and now is already in the world. Little children, you are from God and have conquered them, for the one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world. They are from the world. Therefore, what they say is from the world, and the world listens to them. We are from God. Whoever knows God listens to us, and whoever is not from God does not listen to us. From this we know the spirit of truth and the spirit of error." When we deny the humanity of Jesus, right, we do that not just in some kind of spiritual or kind of theological way, but when we engage in kind of inhumane activity, we are denying the value, the goodness of God's creation, and in particular, the goodness of God's kind of crown of creation, humanity. And in these days, there is a lot of inhumane treatment of one another. So I know we're broadcasting this on Facebook, and I believe we're also doing it on YouTube, but those social media outlets are not always the most humane treatment of people. You know this, right? You get on your social media, and you see a lot of inhumane treatment of people. They don't have the right politics. They don't have the right kind of perception on the country or on each other. We are participating in a spirit of Antichrist when we engage in such inhumane activity. Like, what it means to embrace Christ is to embrace Christ in the other. I quote it all the time. I just can't get away from it. I mean, maybe, stick around here at the church another decade or so, and maybe the Lord will impress another passage of Scripture on me that I quote all the time. But right now, the passage of Scripture that I've been living with for a while, and it seems like I'm going to continue to live with for a good bit yet, is out of Matthew 25, where Jesus says, "When I was thirsty, you gave me something to drink. When I was hungry, you fed me. When I was naked, you clothed me. When I was a stranger, you welcomed me. When I was sick, you cared for me. And when I was a prisoner, you came to visit me." And they'll say, "Lord, when were you naked? When were you in prison?" And he says, "When you do it to the least of these, you do it to me." So we carry that responsibility. Somehow, in the midst of our current context, we have to find a way to navigate between these polar extremes and advocate for the goodness of people. What's best for people? Right? We have to find a way to resist the temptation of making everything political and ideological and care for people's wholeness, for their health, for their bodies, for how their bodies get treated. I mean, it's one of the reasons why this local body, this church, has joined with another 20-plus churches in Polk County. And some of those churches are Missionary Baptist, and some of them are African Methodist Episcopal. Some are Presbyterian. Some are Methodist. Some are Pentecostal. Some are whatever Oasis is. But it cuts across all those various expressions. And what we share in common is we want the common good. What we share in common is that we want to resist the inhumane treatment of humans. Right? We don't want to be inhumane as we treat humans, because that's not a human way to be. The question about Jesus is not, is Jesus human like us, as though we're the standard of humanity, but are we like Christ? If to deny Jesus came in the flesh is to speak with the spirit of Antichrist, it means that Jesus came in the flesh, that Jesus was human. And it's when we are like Christ that we are most human. Like, we fulfill our humanity in our love and service to Christ, so that we are filled with the Spirit. It results in our love for others and our actions toward them and with them. And in that activity, in that life, we find that we are more and more like Christ, and we are more and more the human God has made us to be. So we all participate in humanity, but we are the one sole expression of humanity that will ever be. Like, there's never going to be another Fred Blind. Happy birthday, brother. That's it, right? So we all have our birthday. We all have this time. This is us. This is it. I'm the one and only Robbie Waddell. I mean, there might be somebody else named Robbie Waddell, but that's not me. And this is my shot. My shot to follow Christ. My shot to love others. So, I realize in the more kind of suburban area that we live in, a lot of us might not find ourselves on a city bus. But we might find ourselves on an aisle at Winn-Dixie or at Publix or at Walmart. We'll find ourselves sitting in traffic. We'll find ourselves, maybe some of us, kind of going to a restaurant. We find ourselves at work. Even when we find ourselves online, right, in our digital spaces, let's lean into humane treatment of others. Because I do believe that that is an outcome of embracing the humanity of Jesus Christ. We're gonna come to the table now as we do. And as we come to the table, for those of you who are present here in the building with me, there are little containers that are on your seats. Everyone should have one. We haven't used these very often around here. The top, there's two layers to it. There's a little thin, clear plastic layer that you can peel back and access the wafer. And then there's more of like a purplish foil layer that you can peel back and have access to the juice. If you're online with us, take a minute and grab your elements of communion wherever you are, in your living room or your kitchen. The church says that this is the body and blood of Christ. And we say words like, when we partake it, that we too might become that. It is this, I mean, incarnation is a nice big fancy word. It just means to be in the flesh. Or maybe to put it even more straightforwardly, it means to be human. And that's what we're after here. We are following the human one, the Son of Man. And he is calling us to come and receive of him, become like him. Behold what you are, and receive and become what you receive. Let me try that again. Behold what you are and become what you receive. To err is human, but to forgive is divine. And that's exactly what the Lord calls us to. We prayed, Zach led us earlier by video in the call to worship, in the Lord's Prayer. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. God calls us to that. So we come to the table today. This is the table of the Lord, not of the church, but of the Lord. It is prepared for those who love him and those who want to love him more. So I invite you all to come, those who have come often and those who have not been here long. I invite you to come because it is the Lord's will that he would meet you here. So Holy Spirit, we pray that you would come down on these elements, whether here in this room or in any living room or house or apartment or car or park or wherever else people might be tuning in from. And Lord, we pray that you would make these elements the body and blood of Christ so that as we partake of them, we might become the body of Christ in the world. On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and he blessed it and he broke it and he gave it to his disciples. And he said, "This is my body which is broken for you. Take and eat." Let's take and eat together. And as was their custom after the meal, Jesus took a cup. It's the cup of redemption, the cup of salvation. He said, "This cup is my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Take and drink." Let's take and drink together. Lord God, we are so grateful. We're grateful for you. We're grateful for your Son and Spirit. We're grateful for scriptures that teach us. We're grateful for your church that you have called us to be a part of. And so, Lord, as we have borne witness to this, as we have heard your words and said prayers and sung songs, Lord, may you send us out as agents of your grace and mercy, of your love and kindness and goodness and gentleness, of make us forgivers, Lord. May we be humane in all our ways, our thoughts, our words, our actions. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the presence of your Spirit, we pray. Amen. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you so much for coming out today. Thank you for your dedication. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your generosity. We have at the welcome desk, if you didn't get one as you come in, we have face masks that have Oasis on it. And it has the beginning of the year, you know, we did those series on know, serve, celebrate, and love. And I think it has those action verbs on it. Know, serve, celebrate, and love. And then it says Oasis. So we have one for you. And we hope you'll take one with you. Wear it proudly. And then if you're online, if you're kind of tuning in digitally, let us know. We'll try to get one to you. You can stop by the church sometime. We'll have one for you. We can mail them to you. Thank you, Carol. Before we dismiss, I do just want to say, I want to say thank you to the church staff, Mikkel and Carol and Kaff Nelson and Lexis, who's not in here with us today, but she took Daniel Terry's place as our children's pastor and has been doing a fabulous job. She's with the Upstreet Kids. Also want to thank Robin Grimes, who kind of does our finances, Jessica Sheffield, who has taken the role as our hospitality coordinator, and Angela Waddell, who's also one of our key volunteers on staff. They've done such a great job kind of doing the ministries of the church kind of throughout this kind of COVID crisis. And they did a lot of work in the last couple of weeks to make this service possible and to continue to make the online and digital service possible kind of simultaneously. And I just want to thank them for that. And I also want to thank the elders of the church. I appreciate you so much. Your wisdom, your guidance, your love, your support, your prayers. I really can't imagine. I mean, we wouldn't be Oasis, right? Well, Oasis is us, right? It's the people. It's Oasis Community Church. This is our community. And it's not us without us, right? But thank you, really, from the bottom of my heart. I can't tell you how much I really don't care for preaching at a phone, which is what I've been doing the last 6 months. I like preaching to people. You are so human, and it's a delight for me to do so. And for those of you who are kind of digital and I haven't had a chance to see you today, know that I love you. And I miss you. And I look forward to the day when we will all be back together again. Because this too shall pass. I know it's an odd thing. It's a crazy thing that we're living in. But it has an end, right? A vaccine, therapeutics, more people kind of getting immune. I mean, eventually, in the not too distant future, this will be in our past. And we'll all say, oh, remember when? Remember when there was COVID? Remember when there was the coronavirus? That was horrible, wasn't it? Isn't it great now that we're here on the other side of it? So that's what we're looking forward to. It's not quite here yet, but we'll get there. So God bless you. God keep you. God make his face shine upon you and give you peace. Now, go out in the world and be that peace. Share that grace and peace with all that you come in contact with. And let's make this place a more human, a more humane community. Amen. Love you all. River so full of life, it's flowing deep inside.